By the Praetorian on both YouTube and Facebook. Street investors. Profit colleges make up 10% of the students in higher education today, and 25% of all Pell Grants are given to poor students for them to go to these schools. Their formulas were used for creating monopolies with no-bid contracts from the government. It depended only on the number of students that were in each class. This same funding formula allowed extended periods of public funds for students. Whenever students did not log in for long periods, did not complete their assignments, or dropped out, teachers were told to keep them on the roll as long as they could and pass them, if it is possible. Tuition for for-profit colleges can range from $20,000 to $35,000 each year, consisting of government Pell Grants and student loans. Each student can receive up to $5,500 in Pell Grant money for free, and the rest can be gotten through loans. Pell Grants are free for the students, but not for the taxpayers, if a student does not finish school. The student is also stuck with the bill, and the school gets the rewards without the risk. Profit schools have the worst business model, because they purposely focus on recruiting the poor. They do this and they also focus on students that are considered certain to fail. If a student fails, that means another student can take their place, and more money can be brought in. The more students, the more state funds, and the more profit for the school. No-bid contracts are set up through government agencies to create a monopoly for corporations to profit from.
K-12. 1. All funds concerning education were sent directly to K-12 in Virginia, and they do not handle the management of their schools. 2. Teachers were hired and the curriculum was set only by K-12 in Virginia, while teachers taught students miles away from their homes or an office building on the internet. 3. Academically leading to dismal results, leading to lawsuits from stockholders concerning the students' performance on standardized tests. 4. In October 2030, K-12 stocks dropped 40% overnight. The stock market turned away from K-12, stating that it was a failed and unsustainable model, declaring its stock short and considered as a gamble.
Arizona Virtual Academy. 1. Accused of outsourcing students' essays to India for grading and commenting too. 2. Because of these statistics, Arizona Virtual Academy was placed on academic probation in 2012. 3. Arizona Virtual Academy had 4,000 students in 2013. 4. State funding equaled $730 million in 2012. 5. K-12 made a profit of $840 million from the money that belonged to the taxpayers of that state, not the stock market.
ITT Technical Institute. 1. ITT Technical Institute has more than 140-plus campuses across the country, with more than one campus available in some cities. 2. They consist of over 60,000 students nationwide. 3. ITT Technical Institute's revenue for 2012 was $1.003 billion, and over $1 million came from the federal government. 4. 8% of ITT Technical Institute's revenue is pocketed as profit by the school, and another 8% is classified as other. 5.3% is applied to advertising and recruiting, and only 42% is spent on actual education.
Propaganda about failures within the public school systems. Encourage charter school support. AstroTurf organizations, by definition, is a form of advocacy in support of a political, organizational, or corporate agenda. Designed to give the appearance of a grassroots movement. Stand for Children is an example of AstroTurf organizations. Organizations that are secretly sponsored through government agencies and other interests. Stand for Children wishes to hide behind assessment tests while claiming that these tests are the way of the future in terms of education. They use tests to produce monopolies because producing tests will cost the educational system money. Politically, they can be used to hire and fire educators. This can also be used to fire educators who are about to retire, helping states with concerns about pension reform. They handle public sector pensions, promised to educators without any real ability to cover those promises. The state government has begun to use the educational system as a corporate monopoly to gain revenue, so that they can pay what was promised to their educators years before, and which is rightfully owed. Our students will now become slaves to an educational system, and the corporations that run that system will, after their years in education. You by the Praetorian on both YouTube and Facebook. We thank you for your participation. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, share, make comments. We love feedback.